ప్రపన్న పారిజాతాయ తోత్ర వేత్రైక పాణయే జ్ఞానముద్రాయ కృష్ణాయ గీతామృతదుఖే నమః. హరిహి ఓం. ఓం నమో వెంకటేశాయ. మై పరిపూర్ణ ఆశీర్వాదం అండ్ బెస్ట్ విషెస్ టు ఆల్ ద వ్యూవర్స్ ఆఫ్ శ్రీ వెంకటేశ్వర భక్తి ఛానల్. నమస్కారం. శ్రీమద్ భగవద్గీత సెకండ్ చాప్టర్ వర్డ్స్ నంబర్ 11. శ్రీ భగవానువాచ అశోచ్యానన్వశోచస్త్వం ప్రజ్ఞావాదాంశ్చ భాషసే గతాశూనగతాశూంశ్చ నానుశోచంతి పండితాః. లార్డ్ కృష్ణ స్పెసిఫైస్ the difference between normal people and wise people. Normal people are endowed with a normal life, means a life which is also connected with worries. And these wise people, when I say wise people, you should understand there are people who are married, who are not married, who has taken sannyasa. These wise people means one who has realized about the self. Okay. These wise people, they are endowed with the lifestyle which is worry free. But note the point, not emotions free life, because these emotions, it appears in front of all. They don't become stone, okay, and they don't you don't think, they don't communicate with the world. As I told you, Shastra never denies a pure love, unconditional love. That's what Shastra suggests. Therefore, all the rishis, jnanis, they pray for whole entire jagat. Even jagat guru, the word comes because they love, they can love. When they are endowed with the knowledge of the self, it gives the potentiality to love all the creatures. Okay. That I also noticed, our life is endowed with worry because we are trained. A small kid goes to his father and he asks, "Dad, is there God?" He says, you know, he is working somewhere, because all dads are having lots of responsibility because they are pressurized in the company and they are helpless, and he was working in a computer or something. Is that yes? If it is so, Dad, where is he? He says that he is in heaven. Then kid goes to play. He comes back again. Dad, after death, where will we go? He says, we'll go to heaven. Can you say, Dad, where the heaven is? Then immediately, it's too much, you know. Then Dad says, go and study for your exam. Okay? Don't keep bugging unnecessarily things. Don't think about unnecessarily things. This is how we are trained. If somebody talks about death, if somebody talks about God, if somebody talks about life, unnecessary. they have to worry about their goal. And that goal also fixed like class test, monthly test, quarterly test, and midterm or half-yearly, and annual test, annual exams. They are fixed with the terms of experiment. A student is fixed with exams. It means what? We worry in installment because we are temporary people. We live with a temporary goals. I don't deny the fact of the education system. That educational system, it has got its own way of approaching, because they have to prepare. Without exam, if you study, you may get deviated in between. Therefore, they have fixed lots of tests and exam so that you would get connected and be connected with the subject matter. But that system is being mistaken like every time worry. Go and ask students, and even in India, especially this 10th student and plus 2 students, because it's a public exam. If you go to their house, no TV, no entertainment, no celebration of festivals, and no parties, no happiest things, because son is pursuing public. It's not the matter about criticizing. It's the matter about to think. So our brain and mind is cultivated that a responsible person should worry about his life, should think about your life. But that naturally parents have converted as to worry. And also one more side, when we had sannyasa, okay, but the language we use, when we took sannyasa. Sannyasa is not taken. Sannyasa is to give up something. And people misunderstand that we have to give up everything. Okay, chalo. Because everybody thinks that the sannyasis, why they run schools, colleges, and I'm giving the answer, okay. I'm giving the clarity. I'm not in a position to prove in order to justify the sannyasa. No. Sannyasa need not to be justified. That sannyasa has got still in people's mind, they have respects. Lots of respects, okay, towards sannyasa. Because they know, every Indian knows the position of, position means a kind of glory of sannyasa. Sannyasa is to give up something. Bhuhu tyajami, bhavaha tyajami, suvaha tyajami. Bhuhu tyajami means I give up the earth. Bhavaha tyajami means after earth. It is said in Veda, we reach this Pitruloka, that also I give up. And suvaha tyajami, even I give up the heaven. Bhuhu tyajami, bhavaha tyajami, suvaha tyajami. Okay, after giving up, all the sannyasis, are they sent to the moon, are sent to some other planets, are sent to a cave? I also thought, okay, where should I go? Before studying, it means I don't depend on this worldly object. Means worldly enjoyment. I don't depend. Then I don't even depended on this Pitruloka enjoyments which are prescribed in the Shastra. Even I don't live with the expectations of the enjoyment in the heaven. It means what? Totally free life. I don't expect it. Okay, without expecting, will I become irresponsible person? No. I have to be committed with dharma completely. No question, in a day I will be endowed with dharma for 2 hours. Now, 7, 24 into 7, we have to endowed with dharma karya. That is the clarity. I give up my limitedness. That means it has got a different dimension to realize and understand. Okay. So I am coming to the point now. When we had a sannyasa, so Swamiji gave sannyasa very nicely, and after sannyasa, everybody was congratulating us because in ashram there was a camp on. Maybe 300, more than 300 people. Everybody, they came and congratulated. Somebody brought fruits. That when you take sannyasa, when you see people are responding, then you become very, you know, you will get the place in you. You fix the place in you because vasudeva kutumbakam. Everybody is nothing but Ishvara. That is Ishvara. Okay, one small kid came. And we were standing, three of us. Three sannyasis were given, you know. Three people were given sannyasa. And that kid, he is very familiar with me. And we used to play. That kid came, he said my previous name. And he came with lots of affection, and I always used to take him and keep in my lap. On that day also I kept, oh, come karke, I kept on my lap. And immediately, so near person, he said, Swamiji, please drop him. Swamiji, please drop him. And I said, I dropped him. Okay, chalo, go. Then I said, boy, what happened? You know, now you have taken sannyasa. You should not show this kind of, you know, love. Then, because people were around me, I was not able to speak with him. After an hour, I called him. What is wrong with that? He is a kid. No, Swami, that is samsara. You should keep yourself away from samsara. You are a samsara free person. You should not have emotions. Okay, you should be with only one gesture. That's now I'm not criticizing, okay. That's understanding. Now I have to value the respect towards sannyasa, the respect towards these traditions. I cannot say that you are wrong. You're totally wrong. I cannot say. Therefore, wise people means you don't think emotion free. They will be endowed with emotions, but they are not victimized by emotions. They can think for the world. They can think for the all creatures. Therefore, all this Upanishad came, and all this mantra drashtaraha, they found all these boons, treasures called Upanishads, Gita, and all the scriptures. See, it will take 3-4 days to mention all the scriptures which we have. In all languages in India, all these subsidiary languages even, we have lots of scriptures. They have lots of understanding. That lineage, somehow it was broken. Because of what? Because of what is folded mind, framed mind. And the proper understanding alone will bring the joy. Now, wise people, they are very free. Means they have understood something what to be understood. That something is called as a supreme knowledge. Now, the appearance of both these wise people and normal people, it shows that worry free and with worry. But worry-free life is comment is meant for all, but this worry-free life is meant for all. Everybody can become jnani. Jnani means what? You realize yourself properly and you realize the world properly, as we saw in the last session. When you look at the object around you with the expectation that to get security and pleasure, then what? Entirely your perception changes. It means your self-esteem, self-conclusion about you makes you as a different person. If you realize what you are, how you are, then that self-understanding will bring a different perception towards the world. That's what Krishna is trying to focus, and he wanted to us to understand. Therefore he says that you are worrying. Panditaha, they don't worry. It means they are not free from emotions. They will be focused on dharma. They know the reality. They know how to welcome death. They know, because every one of us, when we were born, we come to know somehow every one of us will die in a day. But we don't worry about those things. But we worry about this temporary destination. Even you may have your goal, you may have short or long term destination's goal, but you need not to worry, because the life is not meant for worry. Any kind of worry. Taking responsibility, more responsibility, doesn't mean that you should worry a lot. That worry-free transaction, that's what the main difference between common and wise people. And the supreme fear and problem is death. They don't even worry for death, means they don't worry for anything. But they will be endowed with responsibility and responses too. And these words is the key words. The main difference is being discussed now. Now Krishna, one by one, he takes us for more understanding, clear understanding. Now we should not forget, this is the topic about an individual. It means when you are listening to me, this is a subject matter about you. That's what the understanding which we should have. Now the next words, let us read it.
Natve vaham jatunasam, natvam neme janadhipaha, nachaivana bhavishyamaha, sarve vayamataparam.
Now, if you are a 30-year-old, before 35 years, if I ask you, were you there? You will say, no, I was not there. Okay. After 100 years, will you be there? I won't be there. Are you there now? Yes, I am. That's what the experience about us always remaining that we were not there. We are there, we won't be there. Now you see, my conclusion, if I ask or if anybody asks, we confirm that there, yes I am there. That our existence is confirmed by us. Means what? Our presence is confirmed by us, and simultaneously our absence also is confirmed by us. Because if anybody asks 35 years before, were you there? Means I was not there. Are you sure? Yes, of course I am sure, because I was not born at all. How do you know? I know myself because I am now, I am conscious enough to realize my existence. Therefore what? I can understand the absence of my existence. Wow! It's a great deal, isn't it? Swamiji, it's not a big deal, it's not a challenging job to realize like a maths. No, let me finish it. Okay, because you have the consciousness about present, therefore you could conclude the past. How can you say, after 100 years, I won't be there? Not only that, if I ask you about your wife or your father, you will say they will also won't be there. How you confirm that? No, Swamiji, we use a kind of logic, you know. The people, they never live after 100 years. Maximum 104. Because I met one person here in Tanjore. He lives more than 100 years. Now his age is 106. That's what I was told. Maximum 110. Beyond that, people won't be there, Swamiji. Are you confident enough to say that? Yes. Why can't it be? Why can't you maybe a special person? Why don't you think in that way? No, Swamiji, I know about the limitation about the body. Ah, you are very confirmed. That's good, intelligent enough. Good. That's what Gita says. He denies all of them. Arjuna, there are three tenses according to our grammar. Though this Sanskrit has got six tenses, that is something other, you know, we will discuss later. Past and present and future. These three tenses. I am at present. I confirm my existence. I was not there. I am there. I won't be there. But it is not like that. He says, before your birth, you were there. I was also there. After that, after death, we will be there. Means you and me will be there. Now we are there. That's what he says in different way. Natu natve vaham jatu nasam natvam neme janadhipaha. And also he includes other people too. It was not the time where you were not there, I was not there, those people were not there. Means what? Double negative becomes positive. We were there. Okay. And after hundreds of years, it's not like that they won't be there, you won't be there, I won't be there. We will be there. Now, you need not have the questions. We are there. Why he brings this topic? Because birth and death, it separates and it brings the difference between present, past and future. Because I was born, I confirm that because of the birth, I have become alive. I have got my existence. I have been manifested. The death, we fix the point where I dissolve. Where I lose myself. The self is gained by the birth. The self can be lost. Means can be, means it can, we can lose ourselves when we achieve death. This is what the conclusion we live with. It's not the matter about the beginning and ending. It's the matter about the self-understanding. We live with the conclusion, by the birth, I have become alive. because of the death, I may lose myself. I will lose, not I may lose. And that too, we are very much aware this death will take place at any time, but we should not think about that. If anybody talks about this, then you people say, means we people say, they are talking Vedanta. Yes, people, you forgot and be endowed with a joyful attitude. You know, keep yourself happy. How can be you happy? If anybody discusses about death in positive way, not to threaten you, because if there is a dead rat at home, without removing that dead rat, you just keep on spraying the perfumes, it means what? Dead rat smell will continue with all other smell, the problem won't be solved. So when you are endowed with the fear of the death, there is a death fear lies there. We don't know how to face it, how to interact with the death. We are not taught how to face the death, and if we don't know how to receive or understand the death. We celebrate. When a baby is born, we celebrate a lot. When somebody is died, we don't celebrate. Why birth is celebrated? Why cannot be this death can be celebrated? That's what the normal mundane life is. But Shastra now, because the context, nowhere else Krishna talks like this. But here is the context. We bear with, learn. We conclude ourselves about the birth that I am manifested because of it. The death can pluck me from me. That's what our conclusion. We are endowed with this worry. That worry, it's being like a foundation of all our happiness. When the foundation is endowed with worry, how can you get 100% happiness? Any happiness, any joyful moment, any celebration, any festival, so you cannot enjoy 100% because there is a fear. So that fear, it is appearing as though it's a different fear. And some people say, Swamiji, I don't worry about death, okay? But I am worried about survival. No, it's wrongly understood. Nobody worries about survival. That worry of death is been, it has converted his appearance as though worrying about the survival. We should understand it. Therefore, this verse, it gives a positive energy to face the reality. The reality of the birth and death, the reality between birth and death, the reality between death and birth. Because it's a law, once you are born, you have to die. Once you achieve death, you have to be born. Now, if you want to conquer the death, you cannot work between death and birth. You have to work between birth and death. We are born, we should not die. That's what the effort is. For that alone, Krishna is trying to make us understand something. We will continue in the next episode tomorrow. Hari Om. Thank you. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnamevavashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. हरिः ॐ श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः हरिः ॐ